Welcome for today's video lecture of Ganit of Maths. Okay. Yesterday we started the practice 3.1 from the chapter 3. So in that first 5 word problems we have learned yesterday. Next 5 word problems we will learn today. Okay. So let's solve the problem number 6. A house was made using 12,23,477 bricks. Another house was made using 45,42,259 bricks. How many bricks were used in all? Okay, so there are two houses, and for both two houses, some bricks are needed. Means bricks were used to both the build both the houses. To build first house, this much bricks were used, that is 12,23,477, and to build another house, this much bricks were used, 45,42,259. So in all, total, in all means what? Total, how many bricks were used to build both the houses? So that means which operation we need to do here? Yes, you're right, addition we need to do here. So let's solve. First house, to build first house, how many bricks were used? 12,23,477. And to build second house, how many bricks were used? 45,42,259. So let's write from one's place. Okay. So total how many bricks were used? Total how many bricks were used, that we have to find. So we need to do addition here. Let's add 7 plus 9 16, correct? So 6 will come here, 1 will be carried. 7 plus 5 12, correct? 7 plus 5 12, and 12 plus 1 13. So 3 will come down, 1 will be carried. 4 plus 2 6 6, and carried 1, 7. 3 plus 2, 5. 2 plus 4, 6. 2 plus 5, 7. 1 plus 4, 5. So 1 stands 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, and 10 lakh. So total 57,65,736 bricks were used in all. So 57,65,736 bricks were used in all. Understood? Let's solve the next problem number 7. In an election between two candidates, Mr. John got 16,23,445 votes, and Mr. Mehta got 13,25,812 votes. 141,347 voters did not turn up. How many voters were there? Means there is one constituency, and in that there was election for the election of member of parliament. Okay, so there were two candidates, Mr. John and Mr. Mehta. So Mr. John got this much votes, Mr. Mehta got this much votes. Okay, and This 1,41,347, these are the number of voters who did not turn up to give their vote, to cast their vote. Means they were unable to come for the voting. Okay, this much voters. So how many voters were there? Total how many voters were there? Okay, so in these, again here we have to find total voters. That means we need to count votes of John plus votes of Mehta. Okay, again in that we need to add these, the voters who did not turn up to cast their vote, to give their vote. Those number of voters also we need to count in total voters, because they are in voting list but they did not turn up. Okay, so while finding total voters, we need to add votes of John, votes of Mr. Mehta, the voters who did not turn up. So let's find Mr. John, vote got to Mr. John. How many is he? 16,23,445. Then Mr. Mehta. And the voters who did not turn up. See, because of this, due to this, we need to write the next number from ones place. Because see here, now in these two numbers there are 7 digits, but here in this number there are 6 digits. If you would have written from this side, then you would have got wrong answer. Okay, so always remember that first number write from this side, but while writing next numbers, you need to write from ones place. Okay, so to find total voters, we need to add them. So let's add 5 plus 2, 7. 7 plus 7, 14. 4 will come down, 1 will be carried. 4 plus 1, 5. This 4 plus 1, 5. And this 4 plus 1, 5. Correct. So 5 and 5, 10. 0 will come down, 1 will be carried. Now see, 8 plus 4. 8 plus 4. 12 and 3, 15, 15 and 1, 16, 6 will come down, 1 will be carried. Don't forget to add the carry, okay? 5 plus 3, 8, 8 and this one, 9, 9 and carried 1, 10, okay? So 0 will come down, 1 will be carried. 2 plus 2, 4, 4 plus 4, 8, 8 and 1, 9, 6 plus 3, 9, 9 and 1, 10. 0 will come down, 1 will be carried. 1 plus 1, 2 plus 1, 3. So total how many voters were there? 30 lakh. So there were 30,90,604 voters. Voters means the people who can give their votes. Voters means the people who can give their votes. And you know, who can give their vote in the voting or in the election? You know, the people whose age is above 18 years. Okay, you might be knowing that. So now pause this video and write this in your notebook. Let's solve the next problems. Question number 8, example number 8, the sum of two numbers is, 11 crore 96 lakh 23,807. If one of them is 2,33,49,618, find the other numbers. So understand this problem. See here, there are two numbers. Their sum means what? Addition. Their addition is given. This 11,96,23,807. This is their addition. Okay. Out of two numbers, one number is given. This is one of the number. One number is given, that is 2,33,49,618. And we have to find this second number. See, so to find the second number, which operation we need to do here? Can you guess? If sum is given and one of the number is given, then to find the another number, which operation we need to do? I'll give you one parallel example, similar example. See, suppose sum of two number is 10. Sum of two numbers is 10. Okay, and one of the number is 7. Then which can be which will be the another number? So sum of which two number is 10? Can you tell me? 7 plus 3. Correct. Then to find that 3, what you will do? This first, the one of the number you will add in this 10. 10 plus 7, you will get 17. Will it be 17? No. What we need to do? Subtract. 10 minus 7, 3. So 7 plus 3, you will get 10. Okay. Similarly here, from this sum, from this addition, we need to subtract this one number. Okay, so let's do it. Sum is given. Sum of two number is 11,96,23,807, and one of the number is 8,16,94,332. That is 2,33,49,618. And we have to find another number. So which can be another number that we have to find? And to find that other number, which operation we need to do here? Subtraction. We need to subtract this one number, one of the number, from the sum. Okay. So let's subtract. 7 minus 8. Not possible. So we need to take borrow here. So from this 0, we need to take borrow here. But there is 0, so cut this 0. From 8, we need to take one borrow here. Write this 0 up. 8 will remain 7. Now from this 10, we'll take one borrow here. Cut 7. Write up. 10 will remain 9. Okay. 17 minus 8. Can you tell me? 17 minus 8? 9. 9 minus 1? 8. 7 minus 6, 1. 3 minus 9, again not possible. So cut 3, write up. Cut from this 2, we will take one borrow here. So 3 will become 13, 2 will remain 1. Now 13 minus 9, 4. 1 minus 4, not possible. So from 6, we will take one borrow here. This 1 will become 11, 6 will remain 5. 11 minus 4, 7. 5 minus 3, 2. Okay. 9 minus 3, 6. 1 minus 2, again not possible. So from this one, we'll take one borrow here. And this one we'll write up. This one became 11, here 0. 11 minus 2, 9. And here 0. Okay. So the other number is... So, another number is 9,62,74,189. Understood, sir? Another number is 9,62,74,189. Understood? Let's move towards the next question. Question number 9. See this carefully. 2 years ago, population of a city was 2,56,83,927. Next year, it decreased by 12,30,982. However, in the present year, it again increased by 14,09,834. Okay, what is the present population of the city? What is the present population of the city? Now see this. Here see, the first the population of city was, means 2 years ago, 2 years before, the population of the city. Population means what? The number of people living in that city. So the population of city was 2,56,83,927. Okay, now see, next year it decrease means what? Became less. Decreased by 12,30,982. However, in next year, present year, as 2 years before, the next year and now the present year. Present year, again it increase, become more, means added. How much? Increased by 14,09,834. Then what is the present population of the city? Here, this is, if you see here, there are two operations. First, decrease, then increase. You know, decrease, become less, means what? Subtraction. And increase means what? Addition. Okay? So, this is the problem of simplification. We have seen the examples of simplification. So, this problem is based on that. See, how will be the equation? See, first population was 2,56,83,927. Correct. Now next year it decreased. Decrease means what? Became less, that means subtraction. Decreased by this 12,30,982. However, in the present year, again it increased, that means added. So here plus 14,09,834. Correct. So there are two operations in this problem. So this is the problem of simplification. So we have to simplify and we have to find what is the present population of the city. So see here, first, you know, when there is example of simplification, two operations are there. Which operation we do first? Addition. And addition of which two numbers? Addition of which two numbers we do? Addition of the numbers having plus sign in front of them. So first of all, what will it do? The number with minus sign, we will make box and we will keep it separate. We will not take that first. We are going to subtract it later. So this, in front of this number there is plus sign, and in front of this number there is no sign. No any sign means which sign I have said you? Plus sign. Okay. So let's do the addition first. Plus this. Seven plus 4, 11. One will come down, one will be carried. 2 plus 3, 5 plus 1, 6. 9 plus 8, 17. 7 will come down, 1 will be carried. 3 plus 9, 12. 12 and 1, 13. 3 will come down, 1 will be carried. 8 plus 0, 8 plus 1, 9. 4 plus 6, 10. 0 will come down, 1 will be carried. 5 plus 1, 6 plus 1, 7. And here 2. So now, from this number, the sum of these two numbers is this much. 2 crore 70 lakh 93,761. From this number, we will write up, and from this number we will subtract this one. Okay, so let's write. Okay, minus this. So let's subtract. 1 minus 2. 1 minus 2 not possible. That means from 6 we will take 1 borrow here. Cut this one, write up. 6 will remain 5. 11 minus 2. 9. Okay. 5 minus 8 again not possible. 1 will take borrow from C 7. 7 will remain 6. Here became 15. 15 minus 8. 7. 6 minus 9 again not possible. 1 will take borrow from 3. 3 will remain 2. 6 will become 16. 16 minus 9, 7. 2 minus 0, 2. 9 minus 3, 6. 0 minus 2 here, not possible. See, from 7, 1 will take borrow here. 0 will write up. 7 will remain 6. 10 minus 2, 8. 6 minus 1, 5. And here, 2. So, the current population of the city, is 2 crore 58 lakh 62,779. So, the present population of city is 2 crore 58 lakh 62,779. Understood? So pause this video and write this in your notebook. So thank you for today and have a nice day.